Discussion focused on gun control and the Second Amendment and what the future may hold for gun laws. Panelists called the issue of guns a public health concern being influenced by public activism.
I am pre-January 31st, Kristen, and I am post-January 31st, Kristen.
Kristen Song is one of the many people that have had their lives altered by gun violence. She lost her son, Ethan, when he accidentally shot himself at a friend's home.
Not only does it shatter your family, it shatters your community, it changes everybody.
Song was joined on a panel with Poe Murray of Newtown Action Alliance, Joshua Koskoff, the lawyer representing Sandy Hook against Remington Arms, and Senator Richard Blumenthal.
It affects every community everywhere in this country. Nobody is immune from it.
The panel was hosted by UConn Law Public Interest Group. Koskoff talked about a lawyer's responsibility and role in upholding the Constitution, including the Second Amendment. He says part of that is to promote the general welfare and domestic tranquility.
Those principles just completely support only one side of this issue.
They aren't just focusing on guns. Early education on social and emotional learning can help teach children how to de-escalate situations before resulting to violence. Blumenthal says that this could help decrease gun and domestic violence. Song has worked to provide violence counselors to work with at-risk students in urban areas to help diffuse violent situations before they occur.
They really do live in a war zone, and they have PTSD, and they have almost no resources.
Song told lawyers interested in pursuing gun reform to be ready for the long road ahead.
Every obstacle can be overcome. It really can. You just have to have the mindset that it will. And you'll do it.
Song says.